My father was a worker, and he loved to work. He'd work on Saturdays, he'd work on Sundays. He just liked it. He'd go to church, but after church, he'd go and work. He just loved it. And I think more than anything else, not because of what he taught me lots of different things, but I watched him be a happy man and work until he was like literally 93. He was 93 years old when he died. So I have a lot of friends, they take vacations for 6 weeks and 8 weeks and 3 months, and they're never happy. So I watched my father, so I like to work. You have some kids that aren't so smart that work very hard that do very well. I mean, I've seen it many times. You know, I was blessed to have smart children. They did well in school, they got good marks, they didn't have problems. But a lot of that was early upbringing. I'd always say to them, no drugs, no alcohol, no cigarettes. I'd just drive them crazy. I'd say every time they'd leave, no drugs, no alcohol, no cigarettes. Repeat after me. But I'd drum it into their heads. And you know, you have to get back, you have to get through those artificial barriers. I call them artificial barriers because you can do something about it until it's too late. Once it's in your system, it's very hard to stop. Like, I don't drink. And it's very easy for me not to drink. I tell people, what are you drinking for? What are you drinking for? I had a brother, Fred, who was sadly an alcoholic, a serious alcoholic. He was much older. He was 10 years older than me, 11 years older than me. And he was as good looking a guy as you've ever seen. He had everything going, the best personality. I have like a bad personality compared to Fred. But he started drinking, and he also smoked a lot. I think it started in college, frankly, but it got progressively worse. And he was really unable to stop. And he'd always tell me, don't you ever drink and don't you ever smoke. He'd add the smoking in because he smoked and he drank. And it hugely affected his health and hugely affected even his look. So I never drank. I really, when you talk about my father, I learned a lot from my father, but I learned a lot from my brother, Fred. And he set an example. It wasn't maybe the example that people would think, but it really was in its own way an example.
I've spent my entire life in business looking at the untapped potential in projects and in people all over the world.
And I didn't like seeing that.
Spectacular people, sometimes underappreciated, unfortunately, but we appreciate them. We know what they go through.
People I know that are really tough and really smart, and right now that's what we need. We need toughness. We need this, we need the brain power, and we need toughness. That's a tremendously powerful weapon if they knew how to use it. They really do have a tremendously powerful weapon, but they don't use it and they don't use it properly. They are terrible negotiators. I think right now what people want is they want competence. They're tired of other things. That's very important to people now.
We must always remember that we share one home and one glorious destiny. Whether we are brown, black, or white, and we are all made by the same Almighty God. I say it is time for us to come together as one united people. As long as you have pride in your beliefs, courage in your convictions, and faith in your God, then you will not fail. You're gonna go out, you're gonna do whatever you're gonna do. Some are gonna make a lot of money. Some are gonna be even happier doing other things. No dream is too big, no challenge is too great. Nothing we want for our future is beyond our reach. You will build a future where we have the courage to chase our dreams no matter what the cynics and the doubters have to say. You will have the confidence to speak the hopes in your hearts and to express the love that stirs your souls. No one is ever going to stop you from practicing your faith or from preaching what's in your heart. In your hearts are inscribed the values of service, sacrifice, and devotion. Now you must go forth into the world and turn your hopes and dreams into action. I know that each of you will do what is right, not what is the easy way, and that you will be true to yourself and your country and your beliefs. I'm blessed with a great memory, but it's very interesting. When I speak in front of large crowds,
If you are reading a speech, it's much easier, but you don't get the reaction. If you're reading, or if you have teleprompters, if you have a teleprompter, or in any way reading a speech, or even looking down all the time at notes, you're not going to get the reaction from the crowd. So I go out and I really, you know, it's a riskier proposition, because when you read, you're not going to make any mistake. Now, I know what I'm going to say, but it's a riskier thing, but it's a much better, when you get it right, it's a thing of beauty.
If I give you one message to hold in your hearts today, it's this: never, ever give up. There'll be times in your life you'll want to quit, you'll want to go home. I've seen so many brilliant people. They gave up in life. They were totally brilliant. They were top of their class. They were the best students. I've seen others who really didn't have that talent or that ability, and they're among the most successful people today in the world because they never quit and they never gave up. So just remember that. Never stop fighting.
And dream big and bold and daring. We have to do that.
Carry yourself with dignity and pride. Demand the best from yourself and be totally unafraid to challenge entrenched interests and failed power structures. And always have the courage to be yourself. Most importantly, you have to do what you love. You have to do what you love. I've seen so many people, they're forced through lots of reasons to go down a path that leads them to something that they don't love, that they don't enjoy. You have to do what you love, or you most likely won't be very successful at it.
You do what you do. I mean, it is what it is. You've learned, and you're an intelligent person. You have to understand that about yourself, otherwise you're not going to be very good up there. And
when your story goes from here, it will be defined by your vision, your perseverance, and your grit. Just think for a moment of how blessed you are. Be surrounded by people who you love and care about so much. Then ask yourself, with all of those blessings, and all of the blessings that you've been given, what imprint will you leave in the sands of history? Following your convictions means you must be willing to face criticism from those who lack the same courage to do what is right. A small group of failed voices who think they know everything and understand everyone want to tell everybody else how to live and what to do and how to think. But you aren't going to let other people tell you what you believe. But the fact is, no one has ever achieved anything significant without a chorus of critics standing on the sidelines explaining why it can't be done. Nothing is easier or more pathetic than being a critic. But the future belongs to the dreamers, not to the critics. The future belongs to the people who follow their heart no matter what the critics say, because they truly believe in their vision. Being an outsider is fine. Embrace the label, because it's the outsiders who change the world and who make a real and lasting difference. The more that a broken system tells you that you're wrong, the more certain you should be that you must keep pushing ahead.
So, you know, yeah, there's a certain energy you have to get. You have to build up the energy. But
it's called the road less traveled. I know that each of you will be a warrior for the truth. Each of you should take immense pride in what you have achieved. The story of America is the story of an adventure that began with deep faith, big dreams, and humble beginnings. Did we take risks? Did we dare to defy expectations? Did we challenge accepted wisdom and take on established systems? Or did we just go along with convention, swim downstream so easily with the current, and just give in because it was the easy way, it was the traditional way, or it was the accepted way. The more people tell you it's not possible, that it can't be done, the more you should be absolutely determined to prove them wrong. Treat the word impossible as nothing more than motivation.